What is up, guys? We're back outside today. It's like 8, no, not 8. It's like 65, 70 degrees outside today. It's beautiful, sunny. We're going to try to finish the Turbo Neon build today. I got my puppies out here with me. Meet up there messing with the chickens. Trying to stalk them out. And then we got Muff. Let's see how close Meat can get to the chickens. They're all buddies. So yeah. So what we gotta do next is splice into there, mount our intercooler after we do that last coolant line. We gotta swap the oil pan out. Probably do that first. That'd be the hardest part. Cause we got oil supply, coolant return, coolant supply. Almost done with the coolant supply, but basically done. Hardest part is going to be dropping this front motor mount and dropping the oil pan to put the new oil pan on there. So yeah, I'll probably drop that motor mount off the front. I'll show you what bolts you need to do, but most of it's going to be done off camera. Move our front bumper out of there. Hardest part is going to be mocking this intercooler up, because I got to move my horn. I'm gonna have to move shit, make intercooler piping, yada, 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 yada. So I'll be back. All right, I guess the first thing I should do is throw this pan under here and drain the oil. So we're gonna drain the oil out of the pan so we can drop the pan. Then we're gonna remove this front motor mount that it looks like it's jerry-rigged from hell, because you can see there's an extra nut on there. But this is an AFX front solid mount, which is pretty cool and kind of rare-ish. Not really. But you gotta remove it from there. There is two bolts here. On the other side, you have to go through the back right here. And then there's one more going up through there. And then there's two right there bolted to the body. I mean, to the motor itself. And then you can remove the oil pan. If it wasn't for that, you could just remove the oil. I mean, it looks like somebody already got this one chipped out, so you can remove the oil pan. I might not have to remove the front motor mount, actually, guys, which is really cool. Cool, I don't have to. I can just pop that 10 out of there. See, usually there's metal right there in the way of blocking that 10, so I don't have to remove the front motor mount. So take that back. We're just going to drain the fluid and drop this oil pan, stick the new oil pan and gasket on there, and then tighten it back up and hook our oil return up. And do the other coolant line, and we might be able to fucking test fire it. We have to hook up our Y band or our O2 sensor. Wait, there's our Y band hanging down. Hopefully it didn't lay on the ground all night. Either way, it gets some pretty shitty weather or environmental bullshit, whatever. I'm gonna drain this oil though, I'll be back. Alright, guys, so we got the oil drained. You can see, yeah, what is that, 4 quarts exactly in there, which is pretty cool. It's pretty much exactly on the 4-quart line. So I don't use any oil. I'm gonna stick the drain plug back in there, and then we're gonna pop all those tens off, remove the oil pan, slap our new oil pan on, and then run some intercooler piping and the oil return. So see when I'm done removing this oil pan. Alright, guys, so we got all the bolts removed from the oil pan. Now it's time to drop the oil pan. I thought it was a spell, so obviously someone siliconed it, so I'm gonna tap it with my rubber mallet and it should come off. Alright, I'll be back after I get this thing off. I'm gonna put a flathead between this little gap right here, between here and here. Just probably it'll break apart, so see you in a minute. Alright, she released just like I said. I just stuck it between here and down. Oh my god, the balance shaft is still in there, but their chain's cut, so it's good. We're good. Everything looks nice in there. Decent. Now I just need to slap that new oil pan on there with the new gasket, so I'm just gonna go ahead and do that. I'm not worried about removing this balance shaft. I have a windage tray, but we're saving that for the horsepower car. But normally you could remove this whole shaft right here, this whole assembly, plug one of the plugs up in there. Hopefully they already did that. I don't see it though. I might have to fix that. I'm gonna check the other side. But you can remove that shaft and put this in there, which is a balance tray, a windage tray. It keeps the oil from going up on the crank and less velocity crap, whatever they call it. So let me swap this oil pan out and I'll be back. If I need to tap that screw, I'll tap that screw, but I'm not planning on it. So see. All right, we got our new gasket on here. It's a little old. It's been sitting around for a while, but it's brand new. You can see it's never been used. I'm just going to stick a thin line of silicone on here just to tack it up a little bit, make it nice and tacky. You don't really need a RTV for these kind of gaskets, but I'm going to use it anyways just for extra security. And then we're going to slap this oil pan on there and hook our oil drain up, and then we'll be ready to finish the rest of the hard shit. But I got this oil pan looking sweet. So, see you in a little bit. Alright, so we got this side tacked up. We're going to lay our gasket on there, tack that side of the gasket, and slap it up on the motor. So, see you once we get that side done, and then once we get it up on the motor. Alright guys, so I got this side tacked up of the gasket. Now I'm going to let it sit here and tack for a couple of seconds, and then we're going to smack it up on the bottom of the motor and hook up our oil return and our O2 housing and all that other good stuff. So, see you in a little bit. Hey guys, finally, now that the sun's down, I got the oil pan on. All the bolts tightened down. I even got one that was broken off in there, so now we have all of our bolts in the oil pan. They're all tightened down, new gasket, sealant. Now we're ready for hook up the oil return, put our drain plug in, and fill it up with oil. Then we can start working on this intercooler piping. But first I want to get that oil drain and that O2 housing on. Because I don't want to be laying underneath the car anymore. I'm tired of laying under the car. At least until it's time to put that intercooler pipe on. Which I might even be able to use the stock intercooler piping place for the SRT4. I mean, bolting it down wise. If not, who cares. But it looks like there's two mounts there that wasn't on the other oil pan. You see the other oil pan is just a little bit different. Oh, I guess the mounts, yeah, see, the mounts are there. That's weird. It's got more mounts on that oil pan. This oil pan's a little bit different. It has these that weren't in that oil pan. Those weren't in that oil pan. It's kind of weird. I'm going to hang on to it. Of course, I'm going to hang on to it. But, yeah, let me hook this oil return up and this O2 housing and whatever else needs to be put under there. And then we'll work up here on the intercooler piping and coolant supply for the turbo. So see you in a little bit. All right, guys, so we got the all the fitting, all the shit on. So to avoid a kink in the drain line, I put three zip ties here to keep it from kinking. We have a zip tie to the harness for right now to pull it away from the axle just enough that it won't hit the axle. You can see there's barely enough room in there, but there is. We had to shave the O2 housing. It is hitting, unfortunately. So, sooner or later, we're going to have to find a smaller adapter just by an inch. Maybe I can screw that in another thread or two and get it away from there. I just want to fire it up and hear it. What else is next? I need to fix that. That's bad. Very freaking bad. I wonder why the speed sensor's wires are all bare and showing. I just noticed that we got that wire, that hose spliced going into here. That's the only one I'm really worried about leaking is that one. Got our oil return down into our pan. Now we just gotta put our drain plug in, fill it up. Everything's done under here except for fixing that now, I just found. Good thing I saw it while I was down here. So, I'm going to fix that real quick. And then I'm going to put some oil in it. And then maybe test fire it. Then we'll mock all the intercooler or everything up. As long as I get everything there. So, see you in a minute. I told you guys before, this car has been nothing but a wiring headache. So, look. This is our issue right here. I mean, not our issue, but it's going to be an issue sooner or later. These all need to be heat shrink. Buck connector and heat shrink. Someone, for some reason, converted it to a 96 plug or 95. For what fucking reason they did that, I don't know. Probably just had a sensor sitting around or what fuck reason. Well, I'm gonna cut this and redo this. Because that looks like shit. Like, what the fuck? Come on, guys. No wonder. This is why I want to find a cleaner RT body. Because this thing is nothing but wiring problems and shit. We might not be putting a fucking belt liner in this car. We might just turbo this thing with stock SRT4 turbo until we can find a clean shell. I want to find either a blue or red RT that's been unmolested. Even if it's, you know, the paint's bad. As long as the body is in perfect shape, the motor's factory, the wiring harness is all factory, I'm good. I'll take everything good off of this and stick it on my built motor, and the suspension and everything, and I'll junk this body or I'll sell it. Because this thing is just, every time I want to go do something, there's always something wrong. So I'll be back once I fix that nasty ass wiring. Guys, now that we got that mess fucking removed, like, I don't think I kept it, but you see I got all new butt connectors on there. Now I'm going to stick some of this 3M tape on there, and then we'll be done with that mess. I'm not going to heat shrink them because I don't want to put heat up in here or fire, so I'm just going to wrap some tape around it, make sure it's nice, and then we'll be done with that. Then we can move on to the next step, which is, should be putting oil in it so I can fire it up and hear it spool. So, it's been a little while. Alright guys, so now we're going to take and cut this coolant line going into the heater core right here and slap this fitting I have right in the middle of it, and then run our hose from here to there for our coolant supply. So I'm going to take this really sharp knife I have and cut it. So let's see if I can find a spot to set you up. I need a tripod really bad. I also want to throw out a very special thank you. I'm also going to thank him again in another video, just in case he doesn't see this. Big thank you to Mr. Shelby Dodge. Go check out his channel. He has a 2.4 slot like this with a whole set big turbo on there. But I want to thank you, dude, for the Christmas present. He sent me a $25 Chipotle gift card, which I think is so sick. That's my and Shay's favorite place to eat. So we were definitely going to use that. I think it's so cool that I have a fan that sent me something like that. I had another fan that sent me stickers, which I thought was amazing. But now another one of you that sent me a gift card for Chipotle. That's pretty sick, dude. So yeah, I'm going to try to cut this right here without losing too much antifreeze, hopefully. Probably should put a bucket over here. I just don't want to cut too far, and that should be useless. Got me two new hose clamps right here. Gotta throw those on at the same time, so gotta be fast. And now I have to take this up here so I can have this tucked away nice and shorten it up there, which is no problem. I'll just cut like an inch of it off or however much to make it nice and tucked. So yeah, let me tighten my hose clamps up before I lose any more antifreeze, and I'll be back. Alright, hose clamps are on and tightened down. Now we're going to loosen it up a bear with our pair of vice grips and chop a couple inches off just to tighten it all back up and nice and tight. So once I'm done that, I'll be back, and then we'll cut a piece of hose from here to here, and then we'll be done. We got our hose right there, so see you in a bit. All right, we got that on there. We shortened the pipe up. Right there's the piece we cut off. I even zip tied it to there to get it out of the way for now. I should have used black zip ties because I'll probably leave it there. I'm gonna put another one right there. I got them sitting right there. Now I'm just gonna cut me a piece of hose to stretch from here to here. Needs to be like 3 inches long, 5 inches maybe. So I'll cut that off and I'll be back. Focus. All right, cut my piece of hose. You can see how I'm gonna run it down. Run it straight down like that. Put a clamp on it. be done with it. Let me zip tie that other one up, I'll be back. Alright, coolant line's hooked up. Everything is tied nice and tight. Nothing should be moving. Now I wish I had somebody to sit here to turn it over while I freaking hold the turbo. I'd like to prime it instead of running the bitch dry. Plus I gotta get the wastegate closed. I forget how that's even. I forget how the wastegate goes. I have to figure that out here next. Try to shut or tie it open. I don't know. I'll be back once I figure out what the next step is. Well, this is what happens when you're in a hurry and you forget. I forgot to put the drain plug in. Fuck me, dude. Almost brand new almost five quarts of oil on the floor. Brand new oil. That sucks. I got like 2 quarts in there, dude, if that. That sucks. Now I gotta go back into the parts store and buy more oil. Got a little bit right here. Shay left. See what we got. At least see if we have enough to fire it up. If not, I'll just go buy another 5 quarts, drain this shit, and then put new in there again. See you in a little bit. Alright, guys. So we have pretty much everything completed that we need to. I got some oil in there for right now. I'm going to drain it after I get it started and let it run for about 10 minutes. And I'm going to drain this oil and put brand new oil in it. But right now, we got our wastegate hooked up. We have no intercooler or intercooler piping hooked up right now. I just want to fire it up and get the turbo running. But first off, what I've always been taught is when you first do an oil change, you're supposed to unplug the injectors and let the oil pump up to the top of the head. Well, right now I'm going to unplug the injectors in the coil and pump the oil up. And hopefully it gets it into the turbo. And then I'm going to plug it all in and fire it up. But then usually I always heard of too when you start a turbo car for the first time or a turbo for the first time, you're supposed to hold the impeller and wait for the oil to pump through it and then let go of it and let it run. So unfortunately I don't have anybody here to help me, so I'm gonna set up the camera as best as I can to do the fire up and the prime and then the fire up, and I'm gonna start it right out here, hold this compressor wheel, let it turn over a little while, let it run, then I'll release the turbo compressor wheel and give it a couple revs or two, and then we'll shut it down and check for leaks and change the oil and do the intercooler tomorrow. So let's set this camera up and we'll be back. All right, what I'm doing now is I'm just gonna unplug the coil. It's actually a little red clip. Push a little red clip to the side. Down, slide this out of the way. Okay, it's disconnected. Now we're going to disconnect our injectors. Injector 1 disconnected. Injector 2. Injector 3. Injector 4. All the injectors are disconnected. Now we can fire the engine and let the oil prime after I find the keys. That's in the car. I'll be right back. Hey, I got the keys. Alright. Prime time. Plug the injectors in and we're gonna fire this bitch. And like I said, I'm gonna fire it, run out here, hold the compressor wheel. There's no tune, I don't even have an O2 sensor plugged in right now, which is kind of shitty. Actually, I'm gonna plug that in real quick. So, let me find my O2 sensor, I'll be right back. Well, whatever, I couldn't get the O2 sensor plugged in. I got it plugged over there so at least it won't catch fire. Now let's fire this bitch. Cross your fingers. Well, again, the AFR isn't hooked in either, so it's not reading anything. Look under here for leaks. Nothing leaking yet that I can see. So far, so good. Cooling up here good. Looks like we're not good on the coolants. Where's our Jerry Ray coolant line? That looks good. So far, so good. Check these other ones over here. Nothing leaking out of those. Cool. We got turbo on the 2.4 Neon, guys. I'm so excited. Turbo spins so nice. No shaft play whatsoever. Completely fucking refurbished turbo. Now we can finish all the retarded shit, like the exhaust and all the shit that's, you know, knick-knackish. We'll do the exhaust tomorrow. That's so awesome, dude. You hear that spool? So, yeah. I guess this is where we're going to definitely end this part of the video. We're going to do the intercooler as a separate video. So, if you enjoyed this video, remember to leave a thumbs up. If you got any questions or comments, put them down in the comment section. If you ain't subscribed, hit that subscribe button so you can see our videos that we post Monday through Friday. This video is going to go out a lot later, but this was filmed right as Christmas. You know, Christmas Day, Christmas Eve. Christmas Eve, Christmas Day, and the day after Christmas. So I didn't post on Monday because me and Shay spent time together, and Tuesday night was probably going to be a really late upload, but at least it was uploaded. But yeah, we post Monday through Friday most of the time. If not, we'll double upload. Subscribe, like, comment, follow us on Instagram, and send us pictures and videos of your car to the email address in the description below. Everything will be in the description, mine and my girlfriend's Instagram or Facebook. And we'll see you guys next time. Peace.